What is good, friends? We are back with the World Cup. I recorded Bluebird's game the other day with FLCL. I think he's on Team Greece, if I recall correctly. And we see another rain team, but this time it's a bit different. We see probably Life Orb Tornadus. Most of the time, I see Life Orb Tornadus on rain. And probably Z-move Tapu Bulu. And then it's either AV or Spax Magnezone. But yeah, what happened? He did go for Volt Switch. So he led off with Swampert. Switched out into Pelipper on the Will-O-Wisp, and then the Mew went for Volt Switch. So this is some cool bulky offense here. What is he gonna bring in? The Tangrowth. Okay, so this is gonna be Dampro, not Spec, so this is a fine play going Tangrowth. But the Life Orb Tornadus comes in now. I assume it's Life Orb, like I said. And doesn't have good switch-ins. Because I assume Mew is like a little bit more Fistev orientated. And it's like his Medichamp check, and this is gonna be AV. This might be able to live one Hurricane. Potentially knock off the Life Orb, but he needs this healthy, because if this gets low, Kingdra just gets a kill every time it comes in if this gets low, yeah. So he needs this healthy for sure. So this is a problem. What is this play? Going Heatran and hoping this doesn't have superpower? That is a good chunk. Doesn't have left auras. I was thinking either Z-move Tarak or Z-move Heatran. He does short taunt predicting Stealth Rocks, gets that correct, which is a nice play. Well, did Kanto's game start? No, it didn't. Nice. So there were two games at the same time for a second. That would have been bad. I mean, Heatran can't really do anything, because in the rain, the fire moves are obviously weakened. He can't go for rocks. He can't go for toxic because he's taunted. So I can see the taunt staying in. Just going for Hurricane again, even if he doesn't have superpower. Because what is this trend doing back to you? On the other side, he can just U-turn out into Kingdra. Yeah, U-turn into Kingdra is a fine play. If he doesn't have U-turn, he can go hard into Kingdra. But he does go into Tangrowth. Oh my lord. Like I said, going for Hurricane again was another option. Because Heatran can't really touch you. Like, what is Heatran gonna do? Like, if it's Z-move, it's either gonna be Bloomdom or Magma, Z-Magma, which is like... in the rain, fire move doesn't do anything. Obviously, grass move also won't do much. And yeah, now this is pretty much in his favor, because oh my god, he has U-turn on Life Orb Tornadus. That is not seen that often. Usually you see taunt, knock off Hurricane. And I actually don't know about the last slot. Probably HP Ice or Superpower in the last slot, yeah. Like, that's what you usually see. I still think the last slot could be HPIs here. It's pretty nice for Zapdos. I've talked about it a few times. He gets in the Pert. He gets to click Waterfall here, and something is getting blown out the window. But yeah, the Tangrowth is at like 50 now, 55. Oh no, it's a bit lower. It's at, yeah, it's around 50. So Kingdra is gonna be a big problem whenever that comes in. When the rain is up, like the rain will end in two turns, but he can reset it. But actually, Pelipper is low, so he might only be able to reset the rain one time, depending on if the Pelipper goes down on the switch in later. What do you not need? This is so tough. I think he might just sack this Heatran. Like, he just doesn't put in too much work. But he goes into Tangrowth. And I guess he's gonna try to pivot, so this is understandable. Because Waterfall still that less than Regenerator will heal. He tried to pivot into Mew, predicted the Ice Punch there, and the rain was gonna end on that turn. So the Tauron is gonna go for a knockoff, get rid of the leftovers, and the Mew is gonna go for Volt Switch, I assume. Goes for Softball, okay. Sorry about Volt Switch, potentially predicting a taunt. Even though the knockoff was pretty obvious, but yeah, the U-turn coming in handy here, giving him the momentum back. Regenerator obviously bring this back to full. And he can go to Pelipper, reset the rain, and basically go in again with his Swampert and his Kingdra. Oh, he goes hard Kingdra first. Do you Draco here? Let me pull up the Kalak Tangrowth. Tangrowth has Kingdra. Draco does 50 or 59. Wow. If he gets the prediction correct and clicks Draco here. No, that's still fine. Like, I think you always go into Tangrowth here. Because if he Dracos, you can pivot out and he's gonna be at minus 2. And if he goes for water move, it's gonna bounce off. And if he locks himself into Ice Beam, he's gonna have to double switch out. Oh my god, he just sacked the Heatran. I think he predicted him to go into either Pelipper or Tornadus there, and he tried to set up the rocks or something. Cause he had to make some sort of aggressive play, I think, to like change the momentum in his favor? I don't know. Okay, this is Metro versus Grease at the moment. Oh, this is updated Kanto? Oh, I think this is updated Kanto, I think. Is it? I didn't realize, because this is an alt and I don't know, like, so I thought he would be playing later on. I'll obviously I'll pause the recording after the game is over and make sure which player this is. But yeah, he's gonna go into Tangrowth here, I assume. Like, I really think the Heatran was the Z-move, man, because if it wasn't leftovers, what else would the item on the Heatran be if it's not leftovers and not Z-move? Like, it could have been Scarf, but that's not a good answer, like. That makes him too weak to Volcarona if he's Scarf Turn and not Scarf Turek. I think he's Scarf Turek or... Did the Greninja come out yet? The Greninja, I could see it being Ash. Yeah, usually you see... Oh, he goes hard into type of Wheel Predicting Knockoff slash Giga Drain. So that works out really well. Tapu Bulu will be able to eat up any hit from the Terrakion. That's just some wild Z move that I don't know about. Yeah, I don't know. Like, I don't think even Z move would all co. And like I said, I think this is a Scarf Terrakion. So if he's like fast Mew, like Mew that outspeeds Bulu. You can go Mew here and Will-O-Wisp, but the thing is, this is gonna be a Z-move Bulu, so it's not like you can like just easily, like you can't just easily switch into Mew here, because if the Bulu goes for SD and there's like Bloom Doom or something, like you're gonna get blown away. He's substitute, so he's not Charizard Scarf. I'm not really sure what subbing did there, but he's Z-move gonna crush, and this will do like 80 or 90, I assume, 94, okay. But he's just gonna get back all the health. Shoutouts to Grassy Terrain and Horn Leech Recovery. I mean, not all the health, but he's still at 59, which is a decent amount of health. So I'm not sure anymore now. You can see I basically, like, I still had it in the back of my mind that he could have been like maybe Scarf Trend, but I was thinking more Scarf Terrak. Was that Sub SD Terrakion? I think it was Sub SD. Yeah, I could see that being Ash Greninja to have like some priority to hit Volcarona. Cause if he scarfed, he could also be Scarf Greninja. We will find that out now. Like Scarf Protein. Not really sure if this is Protein or Ash. But yeah, he's gonna go for Ice Beam here. Or Gunk Shot if he's Protein. Ash Greninja doesn't get Gunk Shot until we get like some move tutor potentially. Maybe in the next Sonic Moon game that comes out, not sure yet if we will get move tutors. Do you... If this is Ash, you don't want to give it the forearm. That could be really annoying. If he's AV Magnezone, I would go hard into Magnezone. But he hasn't clicked it yet, which makes me think that he's... that he specs Magnezone. But yeah, this rain team seems pretty offensive. And I think at least the Magnezone should be AV to like have some sort of pivot. Like a lot of those mons. I know Pelipper has like a decent bulk. But that's it, like Swampert also has good decent bulk. But the other mons, they can only come in on resisted stuff. He goes for U-turn. So this makes me think he's a Scarf Protein Greninja. Basically wasn't 100% sure if he was Protein or Ash. And yeah, he was basically in the back. Like if he went for Ice Beam or Gunk Shot, then the Magnezone came out, he would have lost even more momentum. Cause then the Magnezone would have gotten a slow Volt Switch. He didn't have anything to block Volt Switch and the game would have been pretty over, as he gets critted there, which sucks. Cause that gives the Tapu Bula a bit more health back. If this Tangrowth doesn't have Sludge Bomb, the Bulu might beat it 101. So all he has shown so far is Horn Leech. I think he was willing to sack his Tapu Bulu versus the Grin. Cause he didn't want to just go hard Pelipper and sack that, is what I'm thinking. So Porsche says in the chat, Terrakion plus Blunder said Terrakion plus Scarf Ninja in one game, bro. This guy's using four Pokemon. And Sweet Porsche said Blundy knows this shit. Scarf Ninja is garb digs. It does nothing. If you have it because your team gets red by Volk, then you check again your team. Okay, so it's SD Bulu. And I assume we're gonna see the Z move here. Either the Bloom Doom or the Superpower? Z Superpower? Yeah, exactly. All Out Pummeling blows away the Tangrowth. I mean, I kinda like Scarf Greninja in some matchups, but I understand definitely what they're talking about, that it's like kind of a waste of a Greninja sometimes, like wasted potential. Like Greninja can do so many things, like why would you want a Scarf? So yeah, this is gonna be Mega Zen. Didn't evolve yet. And there's another game, hope that's not World Cup, that other game that started there. He said it's not even Mega. What? I think he just didn't evolve it yet. I assume the Tornadus is gonna go for U-turn here. If the Zem evolves, it will even be a slower U-turn. Because after the speed boost that Mega Zem gets, it will be slow. But he switches out into Mew. And this gives him... this gives him the Pelipper. Like, you do want to get up the range, so Pelipper... so Swampert and Kingdra's water moves get boosted, right? I could see him going hard to Kingdra here, yeah. The thing is... yeah, if it's Mega Alakazam, it can still put in some work. Because it can potentially trace the Swift Swim. But the thing is, Kingdra is at full, so Alakazam is not going to be Okoing that. Even if the Mew goes for Volt Switch, Kingdra comes out. Like, I don't think after Volt Switch, Kingdra would be in range to die from a Psychic. Okay, so that's just staying with the Pelipper. Sacks it off, basically. Going into Mega Zem there, going into Alakazam, that makes me think it's Mega Zem again. Like, I still think it's Mega Zem, even though some of them said it's not even Mega. That shit. Yeah, mechanics have changed in Sun and Moon. If you Mega Evolve, I think you get trace the Thrift Swim and get it immediately on the first turn. But yeah, unless this is Energy Ball Alakazam, there's no way it can Oko this Swampert. And Swampert will get a kill here with Waterfall. I mean, Greninja can live a waterfall, but like, that's not a switching, dude. Like, you're gonna take like 5 million if you go Gren here. Like, I don't even know what his play is. Like, do you. He has to start out the rain turns, he got rid of the Pelipper, but. I don't think he has. He doesn't have enough sacks to start out all the rain turns, like. I don't think Bluebird can win this. Like, even Scarf Greninja, for Scarf Greninja to be able to clean up with Hydro Pump, he would have to get rid of the Kingdra, and for it to clean up with Ice Beam, he would have to get prior damage on Pert and get rid of the Magnus Zone. So like, I don't really see how he can win. He basically sacks off the Mew, which is gonna, like, it's gonna get 2-hit KO'd here. That way he wastes 2 rain turns. Like, he doesn't have any play. Like, the rain, the Pert is just gonna run through. I mean, yeah, he makes this play into Gren, the Earthquakes, which does a little bit more than Waterfall, I assume, because Waterfall is still resisted even though it's rain boosted. But not that it makes a difference, like, Waterfall and Earthquake both treat KO Gren. And JMP putting that smile in the chat, I think he's, a big fan of Mega Pert. Yeah, if he's Scarf Grasna, that's an option. But I'm more so thinking if he's a Hydro Pump, he's gonna click that because it's like rain boosted and will still do a lot of damage to the Magnezone. Because Magnezone would be the potential play scouting for Grasna. Why do people still speculate? Nah, Jollibee does not speak Scarf Gren, someone asked in the chat. I mean, if he has Ice Beam, he can go for the freeze. If he has Hyper Beam, he can go for the crit. But yeah, he doesn't get the crit. There goes his Greninja, and yeah, this game is over. I mean, now Alakazam can trace Swift Swim. If it has it. Like, if it's Megazam, I mean, he can trace Swift Swim here. And yeah, that is. He Mega Evolves, kills off the Swampert with a Psychic. And I don't think he's gonna be able to kill the Kingdra or the Torn. If the Magnezone is AV, he also can't kill that. Yeah, Kingdra just... Like, even Dazzling Gleam, I don't think it would kill Kingdra from full. I assume it would do like 70 or 80. And Dazzling Gleam is not that common. I used Megazam once and I had like Dazzling Gleam knockoff. Because I wanted to be able to like hit Sableye hard with Dazzling Gleam, get rid of chances of Violet with knockoff. Because my Storm matchup was kind of bad with that team, so I had to like at least have some countermeasure for stall. I can see him clicking surf because he doesn't want to risk missing. As he does just click surf and it occurs. Wow, I thought that might not occur because like Alakazam is decent speed death, but I mean, there's a Specs King on the rain. Who am I like what am I saying? Like, it obviously kills. But yeah, we are gonna pause real quick and I'll check who this guy was. Because I'm 100% sure. So they're saying updated Kanto's OP. 4-1 Metro. So like, the thing is updated Kanto. Record is 4-1 now. Yeah, Aim is on the team. I still have to watch Aim's video where he, yeah, about his World Cup game. Because I didn't see Aim's game live because I was recording another World Cup game at the same time Aim was playing. And Poig was a CG must started, so thank you guys for watching, and we will be back with the next game. Peace out. And yeah, I assume this is updated Kanto, because multiple people said it. If wrong, I will put the correct username in the thumbnail. And yeah, goodbye, and in the title, obviously.